A franchise brand can go a long way. Sometimes that's all it takes to bring in a new audience or make other players from other games give this new game a shot. A franchise by itself can push a game. We obviously saw this with the World of Warcraft games, both in its popularity and in its knowledge of its fan base. I promise this is the last time I'm going to be talking about that tiger, otherwise known as my new floor rug. I can rag on Upper Deck all day about their loot cards, but the premise wouldn't have worked if they didn't know their audience. So what about the opposite? What about a good card game with solid mechanics and a good premise, but with a franchise that's not really taken well by the gaming community? We'll take a look at that with MapleStory. It's not like MapleStory is a bad or unpopular game, far from it. Worldwide, the game has over 100 million subscribers. That does include active and inactive accounts, however, it is still an impressive number nonetheless. It was inventive and very unique looking. MMOs are consistently thought to be 3D just because. It made you feel you were in a grand world. MapleStory didn't feel like an MMO, but an entirely new experience. An enjoyable online multiplayer 2D side-scroller. Plus it's free, and free is a great price. When the card game was first announced, the only reason it really got immediate attention from the gaming community is it was being produced by Wizards of the Coast. Wizards of the Coast are the exact opposite of Upper Deck. Nearly everything they make turns into an amazing game. The basis of the online game was really what you've come to expect. Running around, killing monsters, buying new gear and saving the day. General hero stuff. The story behind the card game is exactly the same. You start off as a low-level character, kill monsters, level up, and save the day. So what made it stand apart? It didn't involve you in any lore-based gameplay or try to put you as part of the MapleStory universe. Instead, it expressed what it was, an MMO. A lot of games based off a universe or another game usually will try and make you feel like a part of the universe in some way, be you two wizards battling it out with spells, or a couple of vampires out to increase your rank and nobility. I said vampires. That's better? So there really isn't much of a story to this game, but that doesn't mean it doesn't involve you. Indeed, it involves you in a very different way. It plays out to you. While something like the Inuyasha card game makes you involved in the story by collecting Shikon jewel shards, MapleStory works at the fact that it is a game and plays itself out like a game rather than a universe. The mechanics are short and sweet and are really self-explanatory. In fact, the mechanics are so simple, it's deceiving just how in-depth the card game actually is.
Amongst our weaponry are such diverse elements as fear, surprise, ruthless vigilante, and almost fanatical devotion to the Pope and nice red uniform. Oh,
let's look at the cards. That'll bring us into the gameplay and strategy, and after that, I believe you'll understand. The first card you're going to have to choose is your hero card. There are four classes in the game, each equating to a class and color. Warriors are blue, magicians are red, bowmen are green, and thief is black. Monster cards are your basic breed. They have an attack and life and are used to battle your opponent. Items are used by your hero and grant them special abilities, additional actions, or improve an existing ability. Tactics are your spells and actions. You use them, then they go away. The cards are really your standard fare. The cards and their abilities are nothing new and really don't bring anything new or interesting. The basic premise has been done to death. You have life. You send creatures and cast spells to damage your opponent until they lose. That's your bread and butter TCG. Most games have phases in which certain actions take place. You draw, stuff happens. You play stuff, you attack, then you pass your turn. This is true for probably 75% of the card games ever made. MapleStory has only three phases. The first phase is the level up phase. At the bottom of each card is a character action box. When you level up your character, you put a card underneath with only the box showing. Two things happen as you level up. First off, your character gains 20 HP, which makes sense. This is an MMO, and your character grows stronger. Secondly, you get an additional action on your bar. There are action bars at the bottom of every card. Each one shows what color they represent, their ability, and the level cost in order to play the action. There are no sources or costs in this game. Very few games do this, much less pull it off well. Instead, there are two rules in order to use any of your actions in game. First off, your level must be equal to or greater than the level of the action. Secondly, there is a spot cost on many cards. Take a look at Sherman's Bash ability. Under the level is a blue icon symbolizing warrior. This means at least one of the cards you've used to level Sherman must be that alignment. Next is the action phase. In here lies the complexity through simplicity of the game. During the action phase, you start from the top and go through every action, activating them if you can and if you want. You cannot go back up the list, and once you've gone to the end of the list, the phase ends. I'm going to give you guys 10 seconds to think about this. Well, you guys get it? Really? You can only go from top to bottom and cannot go back up. This not only limits your options in game, but it makes you stop and think strategically every time you level up your character. Do you want to throw in a bunch of low-level abilities and run quickly, or store up a few high levels and hit them really, really hard later? It's a simple rule and easy to grasp, but it's not only when you add on the complexity of building your decks does it really stack up. You need to take these abilities into account when you make your deck, but these cards are still cards. You start to question every item, monster, and spell you put in your deck because of their abilities and vice versa. It's one of those few games where the mechanic I was profoundly impressed with, and I would talk people up on playing the game merely because of the mechanic. The last phase is the attack phase. Here's where you use your spawned creatures to attack your opponent's character or their creatures, after which the phase ends and your opponent gets a go. The entire thing is quite simple, and it's very rare a ruling question comes up with it. The less drama there is in a game, the easier it is to bring new players not only into that game, but into the gaming community. So with all the praise and positivity I not only show for the game, but that I'm willing to defend this game and its merits, why didn't it last long? Well, there are two factors. First, MapleStory is a free-to-play MMO. While that means their player base is quite large and it's easy to get into the online game, the card game is different. It isn't free. You have to buy starters and booster packs in order to play and expand on your game. That doesn't explain everything, but it is a factor one has to consider. So, what's the other reason? It's something I'll call the Sheldon factor.
Penny. Penny. Penny.
Well, if you've watched Big Bang Theory,
which you should,
you know who Sheldon is. He believes he already knows everything about his world and will take every opportunity not only to argue any of your points or opinions that contradict with his own worldview, but he will tell you why you are wrong with the smallest or simplest of statements.
So what does this have to do with anything? Well, quite simply, a lot of the gaming community has this sort of mentality.
There, problem solved.
The mentality usually goes something like this: dragons, angels, and demons are any sort of cool. Anything magic or magic-esque is immediately accepted. People under the age of 16 are not true gamers. Games need to be or feel adult, dark, and or gritty to be considered good. You get the idea.
MapleStory didn't look or feel this way, so a lot of gamers just avoided it and didn't even try it. I mean, why would you? It couldn't be good, right?
There are a few other games that suffered a similar fate. Some were able to have a good couple of years, while others fell by the wayside. It's unfortunate, but true.
Oh, there you go. MapleStory the card game. A solid game with an innovative mechanic and a superb understanding of its fanbase, undone by a lack of support from the general gaming community.